Let us study about Ohm's law. I think in your previous classes, you might have studied the basic definition and fundamental applications of Ohm's law. Here we are going to discuss it in more detail and its differential form also. Right now we have discussed, we know that for a current carrying conductor, we have discussed that the free electrons of the conductor travel with the drift speed given as Vd is equals to mu e, where mu is the mobility of electrons, which depends on temperature as well as on the lattice parameters of the metal in which the current is flowing. And we have just now discussed that current density in the conductor can be written as NeVd. If we substitute the drift velocity over here, we can see that in a conductor, current density can be given as J is equals to Ne mu e. Here we can see that current density is directly proportional to the electric field applied in the conductor, and these Ne mu are the parameters which depend on lattice as well as on temperature. So these can be clubbed in form of a single constant that can be written as sigma e. And another important term you can see here, sigma, which is written as Ne mu, is called conductivity of conductor, of the material used, the metal used in which the current is flowing. This is the characteristic property of the conductor. So, current density is directly proportional to electric field, and here the proportionality constant sigma is the conductivity of metal. Here we can also define another term. We can also define resistivity of a conductor as, this resistivity is denoted by the symbol rho, and it is defined as reciprocal of conductivity. You might have studied about resistivity in your previous classes. Or right now you just keep in mind that resistivity is the characteristic of a metal by which we come to know about how much the metal or conductor can resist the flow of charges. And this reciprocal of conductivity. So if we substitute it here, you can see that current density can be written as 1 by rho. Here you can see sigma can be written as 1 by rho multiplied by the electric field. This is another relation we are having, for which we can write that in a conductor, at any point, current density is directly proportional to the electric field strength at that point. And this is given by this equation 1. And here we can write equation 1 is called differential form of Ohm's law. Just always remember, the differential form of Ohm's law is the relation between current density and electric field. It can also be written as a vector relation. And its simplified form, which you might have studied in your previous classes, will approach from this relation only for a given uniform conductor. Let's continue on the next sheet. Now in continuation, let's apply the differential form of Ohm's law, which we have discussed, that current density can be written as 1 by rho multiplied by the electric field on a uniform conductor applied across a battery. Here see, if we close down the switch, the battery will apply a potential difference V across the conductor. Here we can consider the negative terminal to be at zero potential, then positive will be V volt higher than the zero potential. Now in this situation, from high to low potential in electric field, E is established in it, and for a uniform conductor, we can apply that electric field we can write as V by L if V potential difference exists across the length L, and if a current I flows through it due to the application of potential difference, this current density we can write as I by A if A is the area of cross section. And if we substitute the electric field and current density in the equation 1 we have just now discussed on the previous sheet, let's see what we are getting. In this situation we are getting I by A is equals to 1 by rho multiplied by electric field as V by L. And on further simplifying we are getting V is equals to rho L by A multiplied by the current, which can be written as V is equals to IR, where R is another constant which is written as rho L by A is called resistance of the conductor in which the current is flowing. So here you can see this resistance depends on the dimensions of the conductor as well as its resistivity, which is a parameter which depends on temperature as well as its lattice parameters. So in this situation we can see whenever a potential difference is applied across a conductor, a current I flows and the value of current is directly proportional to the potential difference applied. So here we can write in homogeneous uniform conductors, the current is directly proportional to the potential difference applied across conductors. This is Ohm's law. You might have studied this relation of Ohm's law or this definition of Ohm's law in your early classes also, but this applied only for homogeneous uniform conductors, whereas this was the relation we have studied as a differential form of Ohm's law. It is applicable for any condition, any kind of conductor, whether it is homogeneous or non-homogeneous.